I'm presenting a case of parathyroid carcinoma. A 44-year-old female patient by name G. Balakshmi hailing from Mogadishu, West Godavari district came to general surgery OP, SKMCW hospital. The chief complaints of generalized body pains and multiple joint pains since 2 years and multiple fractures to both bones of right forearm and proximal femur due to trigger trauma. Her history of presenting illness was she had generalized body pains and multiple joint pains since 2 years and she sustained multiple fractures with trigger trauma 4 months back. And she lost 20 kilos in 4 months. There was no history of fever, cough, headache, dizziness, paresthesia, spine, abdomen, or psychiatric disturbances. Past history, she was not a non-diabetic or hypertensive. She had no other systemic disorders. A normal reduction in pedal fixation to bleeding was done to her forearm, and a normal reduction in pedal fixation to intramedullary bleeding to fix her fracture of the femur. There was no history of previous blood transfusion. She was not on any medication. Her menstrual and obstetric history, she had taken an app when she was 14 years old. She had regular menses, 4 by 30 cycles. She has amenorrhea since 2 years. Personal history, she takes fixed diet. She has history of gastric hepatitis since 4 months and she lost 20 kilos in the past 4 months. She had regular bowel and bladder movements. There is no history of sleep disturbances and no addictions. There was no significant family history and no similar complaints in the family. General examination, patient is conscious, coherent and oriented, and at the time of presentation she was indifferent and malnourished. Failure was present. There was no intravenous cyanosis, covering of fetal edema, and no impalpable effect on the teeth, cervical, axillary or inguinal regions. Her vitals were normal. Local examination of neck. On inspection, solitary swelling on the anterior part of left lower part of the neck measuring 3 by 2 cm was seen and it did not move in deep division. It was smooth surfaced and had an indistinct lower border. There are no visible pulsations, no scars and sinuses, and no involvement from the anterior part of chest wall. Pulsation, there was no local rising temperature and no tenderness. All inspection findings were confirmed. A solitary swelling in the anterior inferior part of neck measured 3 by 2 cm. It had smooth surface and was firm in consistency. Had distinct borders. It was slightly mobile in the horizontal plane, but not in vertical plane. Skeletal pulsations were good and no palpable swellings in the neck. On auscultation, no bleeding was heard and all other systems were normal on examination. So the clinical diagnosis we arrived at was a parathyroid swelling for evaluation and the differential diagnosis thought of the parathyroid adenoma, parathyroid carcinoma, cervical lymphadenopathy of Hodgkin's lymphoma, tubercular lymphadenitis and upper primary papillary thyroid carcinoma with secondary cervical lymphoma. Management of monthly blood count was updated. There was thrombocytosis, everything else was normal. She had hypercalcemia, hypophosphatemia, and the serum parathyroid hormone level was 34 times the normal value. Ultrasound of neck revealed mixed hypogenic lesion inferior to left lobe of thyroid, which was suggested to parathyroid adenoma. So a sensitivity scan was done, and there was a soft tissue density lesion inferior to the left lobe of thyroid, suggested of left inferior parathyroid adenoma. There were multiple ground tumors in the right lobe, bilateral multiple ribs and the right scapula. Surgery and excision of left inferior parathyroid swelling was done, left hemithyroid endectomy and left lymph node dissection along the inferior pole of the lymph node of thyroid. This is an intraoperative picture and this is the parathyroid swelling, this is the thyroid tissue and these are the lymph nodes. Intraoperative PTH monitoring, within 15 minutes of inferior parathyroid gland excision, there was 95% the parathyroid hormone fell by 95% of the basal value. Histopathology, a cut section lesion revealed microscopy, there were positive and macrophages, and there were tumor items. There was capsular invasion, vascular invasion was also seen, perineural invasion was absent. Cross picture showed focal areas of hemorrhage and yellowish regions. There were also a system of parathyroid carcinoma. A PI67 INC was done, which was all. It suggested a parathyroid carcinoma, 100 by 10 HPF was seen. So it was also the history of parathyroid carcinoma. Treatment correction of calcium in the postoperative period for hungry bone syndrome was done. IV calcium and oral calcium supplementation were given. Vitamin D3 60,000 units per week was administered. For follow-up, there were serum PTH assays, serum calcium, phosphorus and albumin assays. These are few differences between parathyroid carcinoma and benign findings.
Case, you have got the case from so and so, I don't know from where you got this case. Actually, we have to diagnose the case. The presentation should be like that, step by step. The patient comes with swelling over the neck. So how you are taking the history, how you are suspecting this is the parathyroid gland. That should be in your presentation. And always the presentation should be in the slides, it should be some points. History, past history, you have to mention. Don't write it, personal history. If anything peculiar, then you can mention in the PPT. Because you have given only 3 minutes, 3 to 4 minutes, that's all. So you are in a hurry presentation. So it should not be in hurry. So whenever you have given a little time, so you have your presentation should be like summarize the case. And the MP summarize the case. No? So it should be like that. All the interviews you should delete it. Okay? If you have time, then you can go on talking on the past history techniques. Okay? Management is good.